Hey, what's up, friends and followers? Tommy Paul here. So far in 2018, I'm off to a really terrible start. I told myself I was gonna make a video a day, and then I can't even make this up. I got sick, and I'm still recovering. My voice is still not the same. But I'm back at it again, coming at you from New York, New York, with another video. This is Tommy Paul. So as you guys can see, my hair is a little bit wet right now. I think it's kind of a poetic segue because I want to talk about why you shouldn't use a hair dryer. So I think most people probably already know this, but I'm going to get into the science of why you shouldn't use a hair dryer. So when I first started growing my hair out, I used to blow dry it every single day when I was getting ready for work or whatever because it was convenient, you know? Then I started noticing I was getting split ends and my hair was getting really dry. It looked like my hair was a crackhead. So then I started doing a little research and I was in shock because I found out that even if you use a hair dryer with no heat, it still dries out your hair because there's too much airflow. If you use heat, it's even worse for your hair. And then I found out that if you blow dry your hair after you use shampoo, it's even worse. Because it's really not good for your hair to go from so moisturized to so dry so quickly. The crazy thing, and more importantly, is that it's not good for your scalp. It actually causes you to get dandruff and dries your scalp out. And this is all just speculation, but there's also research to show that that leads to early balding. Now I know exactly what you're thinking. I don't have time to let my hair air dry, my life is so busy. Well, I guess you're gonna have to make a decision then. Do you have time to not bald early, or do you have time to not kill your hair on the daily? I guess that's up to you. So it's my duty now to provide some good alternatives. So let me tell you what I do. First thing I do when I get out of the shower is I squeeze it. You can take it section by section, just squeeze your hair out, or you can get it back all at once and just squeeze it all out. Just squeeze it out with your hands. It's super easy to do. After I squeeze it out, I shake it vigorously back and forth, up and down, blah, blah, blah. Basically just wet dog it everywhere until my bathroom is soaking. Then once it's a little bit drier, I just brush it through with a comb. Now you don't want to do that if it's too wet because it's going to cause your hair to pull out and break. But then once I brush through it, I literally just squeeze it out again. Squeeze it out real good. And then you're literally almost done. Your hair is almost dry. It basically just takes 15, 20 more minutes to let it air dry. And then yes, it's not as convenient. Yes, it's gonna take more time, but you're gonna save your hair in the long run. So please stop blow drying your hair. That's it from Tommy Paul, and I'll see you on the next Daily Bit.